A former Supreme Court Associate Justice also believes the People's Initiative campaign to change the Constitution is unconstitutional. Antonio Carpio says prime movers of the proposal want to completely revise the Charter, but he asserts only amendments in the Constitution are allowed under the People's Initiative campaign.
And I strongly believe it is unconstitutional. Let me explain. The People's Initiative concept was borrowed it from the U.S. The framers of our Constitution borrowed it. And in the U.S., People's Initiative can only amend the Constitution. It cannot revise the Constitution. Mm-hmm. When our framers wrote the Constitution, they embodied that. What should the COMELEC do now with this petition? Then it has to dismiss this petition because its own rule says a People's Initiative cannot include a constitutional revision, only an amendment.
Carpio adds the proposal to make Congress vote jointly for charter change would give the numerically superior House of Representatives an upper hand.
When you pass an ordinary law, both the House and the Senate must approve. The Constitution is the highest law. And this proposal of the People's Initiative proponent wants Congress alone, the House alone, to approve it because it says they will vote jointly. You need only 255 members of the House to vote in favor because three-fourths is required. Then it passes. You completely disregard the Senate. This alters the check and balance.
Rein in your cousin and stop this foolishness. That's the advice of Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel for President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. as a rift grows between the two chambers of Congress over charter change. This is what Pimentel is saying. He's saying the ongoing signature drive for a People's Initiative is not genuine because it is being abused by House lawmakers. He also believes the House Speaker is the one calling the shots.
Sa House ba, may kikilos ba dyan na walang kompas galing sa leader nila? So therefore, the reports actually point to members of the House of Representatives, and our conclusions will point to the leader of the House of Representatives, no less than the Speaker. I hope that the President will now step in, exercise the powers and prerogatives of his office, plus the fact that the leader of the House of Representatives is his younger cousin na meron siyang influence over. Ang message dapat nun, stop this foolishness. Because the People's Initiative as the third mode of amending the Constitution has been hijacked by the House of Representatives, which is wrong, incorrect, and immoral.
Pimentel says as far as the Senate is concerned, discussions to amend the economic provisions of the Constitution are on pause as the lower house continues to push for a People's Initiative.
There was an agreement. There was also an agreement to act in good faith, di ba? And then, apparently, we see some bad faith going on. So, parang suspended po lahat. Akala nila siguro na by filing the economic provisions under a constituent assembly mode, ay hihintuin na ng House yung People's Initiative. So apparently, hindi. So, kung hindi nila ihinto, and then Senate is entertaining amending the Constitution to a constituent assembly, in effect, two modes ang pinupurso ngayon.
Vice President Sara Duterte dismisses speculations she will leave her post after announcing plans to run in the next elections. Joyce Balancho reports.
Vice President Sara Duterte did not offer any clarity on her previous statements that she will run in the next election. Duterte, whose term ends in 2028, asked for support for her election bid in a speech at an event in Davao City on Monday. But the Vice President and concurrent Education Secretary did not say what position she's running for. The next scheduled election is the 2025 midterm polls meant for local positions. 2 days later, when asked what she meant, Duterte insists her speech speaks for itself.
Nandun lahat, nakalatag doon sa speech ko sa Barangay Bagaliera sa Davao City. I think ang confusion is piecemeal ang appreciation ng mga tao doon sa mga sinasabi ko. Ibig sabihin, tinatanggal nila ang isang linya para sabihin kung ano yung gusto nila na interpretation.
But what is clear, according to Duterte, she has no plans to resign as Vice President and Education Secretary.
Wala akong sinabing ganyan doon sa aking speech. Kaya sinasabi ko lagi pag may nung nagtatanong, sabi ko, klaro naman yung pagkalatag ko doon sa aking speech.
ABS-CBN News has asked the Office of the Vice President for a copy of the full transcript and official translation of her message, but her office has yet to provide it. Earlier, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. said he believed that Duterte may be testing the waters to see the public's reaction to her pronouncements. He also planned to speak with Duterte regarding the matter. Duterte was also asked if she believes that her tandem with President Marcos, earlier dubbed as the Uni Team, remains united at this point.
Ang Uni Team ay tandem namin nung pagtakbo namin as President and Vice President nung nakaraang eleksyon. Yun yun, ang Uni Team. Ngayon, kaming dalawa ay na-elect na as President and Vice President at pareho kaming nagtatrabaho para sa ating bansa.
She was also quizzed about the state of her relationship with President's cousin, House Speaker Martin Romualdez. The two are said to have a strained relationship following changes in the leadership posts in the House of Representatives and after former President Rodrigo Duterte called the House a rotten institution, among others.
Tingin mo, kamusta kaya relasyon namin dalawa? The very best description and comment kung ano ang relasyon namin ni Speaker Martin Romualdez is galing kay Senator Aileen Marcos. Marami ang hindi nakakaintindi kung bakit inaatake mo ang kaalyado ng administration.
When asked if her supposed statements to run in the next elections have anything to do with the existing friction with the Speaker, Duterte has this to say.
Hindi ako makaspeculate kung anong iniisip ni Speaker Martin Romualdez. Hindi ko siya kilala ng malalim. Hindi malalim yung pagkakaibigan namin.
Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.
President Marcos honors the 44 policemen who were slain in an anti-terrorism operation in Maguindanao in 2015. Let's get more from our correspondent, Jeff Caparaz. Jeff, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, good afternoon. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Thursday honored the 44 members of the Special Action Force who were killed in an anti-terrorism operation in Mamasapano, Maguindanao. The national remembrance of the heroic sacrifice of the SAF 44 was held for the first time at the Philippine National Police Academy here in Camp General Mariano Castañeda in Silang, Cavite. The ceremony began by a wreath-laying ceremony at SAF 44 monument inside the academy. The president was joined by PILG Secretary Benhur Abalos, PNP Chief Police General Benjamin Acorda, PNP SAF Director Police Major General Bernard Banak, and other PNP and government officials. Also among the attendees were SAF troopers, former SAF directors, survivors, and families of the SAF 44. The SAF 44, who were deployed to Mamasapano to capture terrorist leader and bomb maker Zulkifli Abdihir, also known as Marwan, were ambushed by members of the Moro Islamic Liberation Front, the Bangsamoro Islamic Freedom Fighters, and local armed groups in January 25, 2015. President Marcos said their bravery will not be forgotten.
Today we remember their heroism and honor the sacrifice that they have made. It is a debt that we will never be able to fully pay. We would also be disrespecting their memory if we give quarter to those who terrorize our people. We would be devaluing their valor if we cede our territory to those who would trespass upon it. It is a clarion call for unity and action against any challenge that we might face. Huwag natin pababayaan ang kapayapaan na kanilang ipinaglaban. Sa pagpupugay sa SAF 44, patuloy tayong magsisikap tungo sa isang bagong Pilipinas.
Carmina, 67 people, including 5 civilians, died that day. A Senate investigation after the bloody incident showed that the lack of coordination between police generals and militants on the ground led to the slaughter of the elite unit. Marcos Jr. was among the then senators who reject proposals to reopen congressional investigations that found then President Benigno Aquino III liable for the Mamasapano tragedy. Marcos Jr., who was then the chairperson of the Senate Committee on Local Government, pushed for the filing of cases against 90 members of the Moro Islamic Liberation Front who took part in the killing of the SAF 44. In 2017, former President Rodrigo Duterte signed Proclamation No. 164, Series 2017, or the National Remembrance for the Heroic Sacrifice of the SAF 44, as a constant reminder of the continuing sacrifices made by our valiant uniformed men and women of the PNP.